Eastern Catholic bishops from across Europe have been in Rome for annual meetings. The focus this year has been on working together between the different Eastern churches in Europe. These churches are in full communion with Rome, but maintain their own traditions, especially in their liturgies. Bishop Hlib Lonchyna is the Bishop Emeritus of the Ukrainian Catholic Eparchy of the Holy Family of London and the Apostolic Administrator of St. Vladimir the Great of Paris. He participated in the meetings this week and joins us now from Rome. Bishop, what do you think is the biggest challenge facing Eastern Catholics right now?
The challenge that all Catholics have in the world, I mean, there's secularization, there's globalization, there is also a certain form of persecution in the form for example, different laws that are enacted or different mentalities that are taking shape. So these are the same challenges that all Catholics face.
And of course, as you know, Ukraine has had ongoing internal struggles and an open conflict with Russia over the Crimea region. Other Eastern churches have ongoing conflicts in their homelands as well. Did this issue come up in your meetings, and what did you have to say about that?
Most definitely. I mean, there's a war going on in Eastern Ukraine, which we cannot forget. I mean, our brothers and sisters are dying there. The people in the villages are very often left and abandoned to their own cares. Luckily, we have the Caritas Ukraine, which is helping them in a great deal. And during our meetings, we are always praying for peace in Ukraine. It is always being mentioned that every day there are casualties in this war. So it's a great preoccupation for all of us.
In October, the Vatican will hold a meeting of bishops discussing the Amazon region. It's expected the topic of married priests will be brought up, and it's a controversial one. Of course, Eastern Catholic churches have the tradition of married priests. How does that work?
Indeed, we do. This is a very old tradition where one first gets married and then he may become a priest. We have both married priests and celibate priests and religious priests. So there are these three groups that we have, and we all cooperate with each other and to evangelize our people.
And tell me a little bit more about how that works, because like you say, you have different people from different backgrounds. Like you say, some who are married, some who remain celibate. How are they able to work together and really minister the gospel with their different talents and abilities?
When a priest is married and he has a family, he has a parish, usually he is in that parish for a good number of years. So he gets to know the people very well. He will baptize them and he will lead them throughout their lives. Then he will baptize their children. Their children grow up with his children. It's a very family affair. The priest is very close to his people. Of course, the celibate priests also are very zealous, and they give all of themselves to evangelization and to pastoral work.
Well, it's so interesting to hear more about the Ukrainian Greek Catholic Church and about your meeting there in Rome. Bishop Hlib Lonchyna, Apostolic Administrator of St. Vladimir the Great of Paris, thanks so much.
Thank you. God bless you.